everyone, we are Group 6.
Come and join us as we see the beautiful city.
Today, everyone, I will tell you the legend of Olongapo City. Once upon a time, along the shores of Subic Bay, there was a village. Its leader, an old man, was famous for his love and care for his tribe. The leader was known as Apo.
However, because of his greatness, evil men with intention of conquering his tribe became envious of him and killed him by cutting his head off and impaled it on a stick. A kid crying shouted, "Ulo ng Apo," that later became Olongapo. Today, the legend still lives and will forever be remembered.
Another new episode, today the legend still lives and will forever be remembered. Maraging park for children and event, a place where children can play in a playground area. The place is safe because it's surrounded by the fence. The park is full of heritage space. There also an open theater for events and parking.
And U.S. Navy Hospital Ship.
1951, a group of dedicated men from the Philippine Department headed by the government, Commander James Underwood, agreed with the local U.S. military authorities that an American kingdom would be a great asset to the Olongapo community and also serve as a home away from home. For visiting servicemen, Don Russell, a World War II Navy veteran, gathered equipment necessary to organize a post, drew up a constitution and an election for both officers. In short, together, Subic Bay Post number 41, born with Don as the first post commander.
Street life. What are you waiting for? Check it out.